Hi all, today we are going to discuss about magnetic boundary conditions. So let us take, for example, I am taking an interface between two types of medium. Let us assume I am taking the region 1 above z is greater than 0 axis, and I am taking another region, that is region 2. Region 1 is having a permeability of mu 1 and region 2 is having a permeability of mu 2. And let us assume the magnetic field intensity is moving from medium 2 to medium number 1. So I am taking this one as the value as B2, or it is making an angle of with respect to the normal component, because normal component will be this one. This I can write as B2, the normal component. Let us assume it is making an angle of theta 2. So whenever it goes through the interface, it will change its angle. We are going to see what is the angle that is subtended, how it is changed, and what is the magnitude. Let us assume from here the B1 is changed. So B1 is some tilted like this. So this is my value of B1, or otherwise with respect to the normal component, because normal component will be B1 in the normal direction. Let us assume it is making an angle of theta 2. I want to find this theta 1 and theta 2, and what is the magnitude of B1 and B1n or whatever components required. So in order to get these things, so two type of things are applied. To get the normal components, it is better to apply the Gauss law in magnetostatics. So for that we will take a surface. So this surface, we will take the height is equal to delta H, and let us assume this surface is having this surface area as delta S. So here I can tell the normal component will be like this. This is my B1n. Here the flux is entering, this is my equal to B2n. So we will take it when this delta H is approaching to 0, we can easily calculate the normal components. So similar way, if you want to calculate the tangential component, for calculating the tangential component, I can take a rectangular loop. Let us assume this rectangular loop I am taking like this, A, B, C, D, closed rectangular loop. I am moving from A to B, B to C, C to D, and D to A. Let us assume the width of this rectangular loop is equal to delta W, and the height is equal to delta H, and this height tends to 0, so that can be neglected, A and B. So this will be my tangential component. So we can tell this as B1t, or for calculating H generally we go for this. So this will be H1t, and this I am taking as H2t. Respect to components, we will find it one by one. And along with this, let us assume this boundary is having, one of these material is having a surface current density of some value K amperes per meter, surface current density. So in that case, how to calculate these things? So to determine the normal component, we apply the Gauss law of magnetostatics. So when you apply the Gauss law of magnetostatic, it tells that closed integration of B dot ds is equal to 0. So now I have to take the closed integration of B dot ds. So I am taking this surface. So this will be top, bottom, and the sides we have to take the total surface integration. When you take the surface integration, it is telling that it is equal to 0. So if I am taking as delta H tends to 0, so automatically the side surface will become equal to 0, because delta H is approaching to 0, only top and bottom will be remaining. So I am taking the integration for this. I am assuming that delta H is tending towards 0, or I am finding at the boundary conditions. So when you are applying this, so this will be B1n multiplied by delta S. This is in the first surface, and the second surface you can see that B2n is going inwards, not outwards, because surface expands in the outward direction. So we are going against the direction of the surface. So this will become equal to B2n into delta S. This will be equal to 0. So from this I can tell that B1n is equal to B2n. This is the first observation we got. So from these normal components, I can calculate my value of H, because we know B is equal to mu multiplied by H. So this I can write as mu 1 into H1n is equal to mu 2 into H2n. So now coming to the magnetization vector, we know the magnetization vector again in turn depends on the value of the H, because magnetization vector is nothing but the chi, that means susceptibility, multiplied by the value of H. So from this I can calculate this one as this mu 1, this H1n, because this I want to convert to H form, so M form. So this one will be H mu 1. This, let us take it as M1n divided by chi 1, magnetic susceptibility, or chi M1 or chi 1m. So this will be equal to mu 2 multiplied by M2n divided by chi 2m, or chi m2, whatever you write. So this is what we get, because why this reason is, since the m is equal to chi multiplied by h. This is the reason. Or from this, h is equal to m by chi. So that's why I have represented like this. So from this, I can calculate my value of m to n. That will be equal to chi 2m divided by chi 1m. This will be multiplied by mu 1 multiplied by mu 1 divided by mu 2 into m1n. So in this form, if you know the magnetization vector m1n, we can calculate m2n easily. Now to get the tangential component, to get the tangential components, because there is a closed line integral we can take, so this closed line integral we can obtain using Ampere's circuital law. So I am applying the Ampere's circuital law. So I am just drawing that boundary condition, only that rectangular loop here. So I am moving from A, B, C, D, I am moving in this direction. So this is my delta H, and this is my value of the delta W, the change in the width. So here, if I am taking this delta H tends to 0, it will come to the surface. So I am not going to do the integration of this one. So here the tangential component, let us assume the tangential component in the first side, this one equal to H1T. And in the second side, this is equal to H2T. I have referred that component in the tangential direction. That B I have referred to the tangential direction, because this is my value of B2. And accordingly, this is my value of B1. So this can be resolved into the tangential component. This will be equal to B1 tangential component. Similarly, this B2 tangential component will be like this. This is B2 tangential component. It will be referred in the tangential direction. Agree with me? That's why I have written like this. So now I can do this. Apply the Ampere circuital law. Ampere circuital law will be closed line integration of H dot dl will be equal to the current enclosed. This is what we studied in Ampere circuital law. So I am applying in this loop as delta H tends to 0. I can write that H1T multiplied by delta W. And in this delta H, because delta H tends to 0, we can neglect it. So minus H2T multiplied by delta W is equal to current enclosed. Let us assume the surface current density is equal to K. That will be multiplied by delta W to get my surface value of the current or the current enclosed. Here K is the surface current density at the boundary. So from this I can write that H1T minus H2T will be equal to K. This is what is obtained. So now from this equation I can calculate, because H is nothing but B is equal to mu into H, or H is equal to B by mu. So this I can write as B1T divided by mu1 is equal to minus B2T divided by mu2. This will be equal to the current density. This is what we got. So now this can be written like this. M2T will be equal to chi 2M divided by chi 1M into M1T minus chi 2M into K. I am not deriving this. You can try to derive it. If you are not getting, you can ask me. Because derivation is easy. That's why I am not deriving this one. Okay. Up to here, I hope it is clear to you. Okay. Now, let us proceed further. So, I am just proceeding further. So, let us take the case. This H1 and HT1. So, this one I can write as this H1 minus H2. Because H1 and H2 are there. H1 minus H2 cross product with AN21. Because we are taking the cross product with AN21, this can be written as K from the vector identity. You can please check there. Or from this, I can tell that H1 minus H2, this can be written as this K cross product with AN12. So what is this AN21? This AN21 is the unit vector normal to boundary directed from region 2 to region 1. It is directed from region 2 to region number 1. So in this way also we can solve. I am going to explain this in the numerical. So why I have taken like this, this will be clear there. So please don't confuse here. So now let us take the case there is no surface current density. So in that case K will be equal to 0. So if I am taking K is equal to 0, I can write my value of H1T is equal to H2T. So from this I can tell that B1T divided by mu1 is equal to B2T divided by mu2. So same way you can derive for the magnetization vector. And second one we already derived previously, that B1N is equal to B2N for the normal component. So from this let us try to calculate this. So the tangential component I can write as B1T. The tangential component is nothing but B1 into sin theta 1. So let us go to this, or let me draw here only. So I am drawing the boundary. So this is my value of b2, this is my value of b1, so this is my value theta1, and with respect to this one, this is my value of theta2. So I want to calculate the tangential component. Tangential component means tangential component will be like this. These are the tangential component. Tangential component will be obtained by taking sine of the angle. You agree? So b1 sine theta 1 divided by mu 1 will be equal to b2 sine theta 2 divided by mu 2. And similarly, this b1 and normal component. Normal component can be obtained by taking the cosine of the angle. So this will become equal to b1 cos theta 1 is equal to b2 cos theta 2. This is what is obtained. So by dividing these two equations, I can write this as tan theta 1, because I am dividing this one with this one. So b1, b1 will cancel. Sin theta 1 by cos theta 1 will be tan theta 1 divided by, similar way, second side, tan theta 2, this will be equal to mu 1 divided by mu 2. This is what is obtained. Or from this I can write mu 1 cot theta 1 is equal to mu 2 cot theta 2. So if you know theta 1 of a medium and you know the value of mu 1 and mu 2, you can easily calculate what will be the angle in the second medium. If you know one angle, you can calculate the second angle using this formula. Tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to mu 1 divided by mu 2. Let us take one example so that this concept will be clear to you. So I am taking one example. The example I am taking, the magnetic, sorry, I am writing on a glass screen, so it is gliding, so handwriting doesn't come properly. Please try to understand the concept. I am uploading the complete handwritten material in the description of this video. You can please download from that link. So magnetic materials are separated by a surface Z is equal to 0 having permeabilities mu r1 is equal to 4 and mu r of the second region is equal to 7 respectively, and region 1 is at Z is greater than 0, and the region 2 is at Z is less than 0. Z less than 0 is region 2, and Z greater than 0 is region 1. So it is also mentioned the surface current density is, the surface current density is given, Ks is equal to 60 times of Ax amperes per meter. Kx is given at the boundary. For the field B1 is equal to Ax minus 2 times of Ay minus 3 times of Az millitesla in region 1, find the flux density B2 in region 2. Flux density B2 in region 2. It is given that there is a surface. So this surface is having along Z is equal to 0. So below this, that means Z less than 0 is having the region 2, and Z greater than 0 is that region 1. So it is given as region 1, it is given as region number 2. So B is making some angle here. This is my angle of B2. So because of this, so let us assume it is making an angle of some value theta 2. So because of this, the B1, so B1 is coming like this. So B1 is making an angle of theta 1. So it is asked, B1 is given here, it is asked to find what is the value of B2. So let us try to find it now. So as the boundary is along Z is equal to 0, so we can tell the normal component will be along the Z direction, because boundary is in the Z plane. Z is equal to 0 means in the Z plane. So that's why you can tell that B1n, the normal component of B, will be equal to, out of B, whatever is the Z component, that will be the Z component. So B1 is equal to Ax minus 2 times of Ay minus 3 times of Az. So this Z component I am writing here. So this will be 3 times of Az. Is it clear? And now that remaining component will be the tangential component. So tangential component will be equal to the vector B minus vector B1n. So if you subtract it, you will get it as Ax minus 2 times of Ay. That means B I have divided into tangential component and the normal component. So now first I am applying the normal boundary conditions. So applying normal boundary conditions. So I can write as B2n is equal to B1n. Agree with me? So this will be equal to, because B1n we have just calculated as minus 3 times of AZ, same thing will be there for B2n also. Let us take it as equation number 1. So we already got B2, because B1 I got the value of minus 3 times of AZ, so B2 also I got as minus 3 times of AZ. So one component of B2 is obtained. Now remaining components I have to calculate. So for that I am applying tangential boundary conditions. So by applying the tangential boundary conditions, we know that h1t minus h2t, this will be equal to the charge enclosed, or from this I can calculate as b1t by mu 1 minus b2t by mu 2, this will be equal to the charge enclosed. This is one way of calculating. Or another way of calculating is, I can take my value of h1 minus h2, we have just seen that previously, this can be cross product with a21 an normal component from 2 to 1. So this normal component, this will be equal to the value of ks. So this way also I can get it. Or similarly, from this I can calculate as b1 multiplied divided by mu 1 minus b2 divided by mu 2, this I can take as cross product with the normal component, this will be equal to current enclosed. So from region 2 to region 1, because we are going from z is equal to negative to z is equal to positive, so this component we are taking, this is the normal component that is going from region 2 to region 1. So region 2 to region 1 we are going around positive z direction, so this normal component will be AZ. Please remember this one. So now I am just substituting whatever we know. So the value of B1 we know is equal to AX minus 2 times of AY minus 3 times of AZ divided by mu is equal to mu naught into mu r. So mu r is given as 4 multiplied by mu naught minus, because B2 I don't know. So that B2, let us take it as B2 in the x direction AX plus B2 in the y direction AY plus B2 in the z direction in the AZ, this will be divided by the, what is the value, 7 into mu naught. So this value will be equal to the charge enclosed. So that will be equal to 60, current enclosed is equal to 60 times of AX. This is the current density. So now we have to equate both the sides. So for that I am simplifying this. So when you simplify this, this will be equal to 7 times of AX minus 7 into 2, 14 times of AY minus 21 times of AZ minus 4 times of B2X in the AX direction minus 4 times of B2Y in the Y direction minus 4 times of B2Z in the AZ direction. So this component will be equal to 60 multiplied by, this denominator comes to the second side. So 4 into 7 will be 28 times of mu naught. This will be in the direction of AX. Agree with me? So this I am further simplifying. So when you, so this I have forget. So here you have to take the cross product with normal component, right? So cross product with AZ is missing. So this cross product with AZ, so AX cross AZ will be equal to minus AY. So this I can write as minus 7 times of AY. So similarly, AY cross AZ will be AX. So that's why 14 times of AX. AZ cross AZ will be equal to 0. Similar is the case the second one. Minus 4 is there. So this will become plus 4 times of B2X in the direction of AY minus 4 times of B2Y. AY cross AZ will be equal to AX plus 0. This will be equal to this, if you take the product on the right hand side, this will become 1680 multiplied by mu naught in the direction of AX. So this I can further simplify. X component, Y component I am separating. Minus 14 minus 4 times of B2Y in the direction of AX plus minus 7 plus 4 times of B2X in the direction of AY. This is equal to 1680 mu naught in the direction of AX. Now I can compare component by component. So when you compare the component by component, we will get it as B2X, because AY component is not there in the denominator, second side RHS. So that will be equal to 0. So B2X when you equal to 0, you will get it as 7 divided by 4. This will be equal to 1.75. So we got the X component of B2. So similar way, the second one, if you are equating minus 14 minus 4 times of B2Y, this will be equal to 1680. So 1680 times of mu naught. So mu naught we know is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power of minus 7, just substitute this one. If you substitute and solve for the value of by, I am directly writing the answer, this will be equal to minus 3.5. So from equation number 1, 2 and 3, I can write my value of b2. b2 will be the x component we got as 1.75 times, and similarly the y component we got as minus 3.5, and z component we got from the normal component as minus 3. This will be in the z direction. This is in milli Tesla. So similar way, if I tell that so much is the angle subtended in the first plane, what is the angle subtended in the second plane? How to calculate it? Take the ratio tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to mu 1 divided by mu 2. So using that you can calculate. I hope that what are the boundary conditions, how the signal will behave, magnetic signal when it is crossing a boundary or moving from one boundary to another boundary or one material to another material, is clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.